Hi dear students, so in the last class we discussed about our lesson 4, air and water, and we already studied about air. So what do you mean by air? Air is a mixture of many gases. Air is a mixture of many gases like oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, etc. Okay. So we cannot see air, but we can feel air when it moves. And we also studied about uses of air. All living things need air for breathing. We need air for breathing. And we need oxygen for breathing. And like plants also living things. And all living things in the nature needs air for breathing. And we also studied about properties of air and air pollution. So what do you mean by air pollution? Dirtying of air is called air pollution. Dirtying of air is called air pollution. And if we breathe a dirty air, it causes many diseases like asthma and other health problems, etc. Okay. And now we are going to study about water. So water is another important thing that we need to live in earth. That means the life exists in earth due to the presence of air and water. The life exists in the air, in the earth, due to the presence of air and water. So we cannot imagine without life without water. So water is an important thing that we need, the water we need to live on earth. So what are the importance of water? So the water is also found in ponds, rivers, lakes, etc. Okay, and these are called water bodies. Okay, so the ponds, rivers, lakes, these are the water bodies, and these are the sources of water. And the water bodies get water from rain, and the rain water goes under the ground and to form underground water, and these are the sources of water. So what are the sources of water? A lake, pond, river, seas, etc. So we get water from mainly from rain, and the water bodies are lakes, rivers, seas, etc. And there are water can be seen in three different states. There are three states of water: solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. So today we are going to study about different states of water and water cycle, about water cycle. So the first topic is different states of water. Different states of water. Okay, so we have also seen water and water. So what is shape of water? So water does not have any shape, and water gives the shape of the container in which the water kept. Okay, so if we take water in a bucket, then it takes the shape of the bucket. And if you take water in your water bottle, and the water take the shape of the water bottle. So water does not have any fixed shape. So water does not have any fixed shape. And water has three states. So what are the three different states of water? They are solid state. First one, solid. Solid. Second one, liquid. L-I-Q-U-I-D. Liquid. And third one, gas or gaseous state. Okay. So solid, S-O-L-I-D. Solid. Liquid, L-I-Q-U-I-D. Liquid and gas. So gaseous state, G-A-S-E. water in a freezer, then it changes to ice. So ice is the solid form of the water. Then if we boil water, it changes into water vapor. If we keep water into the freezer, then it changes into ice, and this is the solid form. If we boil water, then it changes to water vapor, that is gas. So if we heat the solid state, it changes into liquid. If we heat liquid state, then it changes into the gaseous state. Okay. If we take water into a freezer, water in a freezer, then it changes into ice. So ice is the solid state of the water. So which is the solid state of the water? Yes, very good. Ice is the solid state of the water. Okay. So which are the three states of water? Solid, that is ice, then liquid, that is water, and gas, that is water vapor. Very good. Then, so these are the three states of water. Then we are moving to studying about water cycle. Okay, so the journey of water is called water cycle. Simply, water cycle means the changing of water in nature is called water cycle. The changing of water in nature is called water cycle. Which means the water present in the various water bodies on the earth and gets heated by the sun and evaporates to form water droplet. Water droplets of water vapor. Which means the process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. So the water present in the water present in the various water bodies on the earth gets heated by the sun and it evaporates to form water vapor, and this is known as evaporation. And the water vapor rises high where it comes in contact with cool air above, and it condenses to form tiny water droplets. It condenses to form very tiny water droplets, and the tiny water droplets stuck together to form clouds. The tiny water droplets stuck together and it forms clouds. And this is called as the water droplets get too heavy for the clouds and to hold. They come down on the earth's surface and is called the precipitation. Okay. So in such way, the journey of water takes place. So this is called a water cycle. Simply, water cycle means the changing of water in nature is called a water cycle. And there is three processes like evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. Okay. So evaporation means the process of changing water into water vapor. The process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. And the process of changing water vapor into water is called condensation. Okay. So next one is evaporation and condensation. So first one, evaporation. So what is spelling of evaporation? E-V-A-P-O-R-A-T-I-O-N. Evaporation. So what do you mean by evaporation? The process of changing water into water vapor. If we heat or the water gets heated, then it changes into water vapor, and that process is called evaporation. So the process of changing water into water vapor, the process of process, the process of changing 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 water into water vapor, water into water vapor is called evaporation. Water into water vapor is called evaporation. Okay. So the process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. And the second one is condensation. So what do you mean by condensation? the process of changing water vapor into water. The process of changing water vapors into water is called condensation. So evaporation means the process of changing water into water vapor. And the second one, condensation. 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 So condensation means the process of changing water vapors into water. The process of changing water vapor into water. So here evaporation means changing water into water vapor, and condensation changing of water vapor into water vapors into water. Changing water vapors into water is called condensation. Okay, so first point, evaporation. And evaporation is a process in which the water changes into water vapor, and in condensation the water vapors changes into water. That is called condensation. So these are the two important process explained in water cycle. Okay, and the third one is precipitation. So precipitation means is the tiny water droplets are formed after condensation stuck together, and it forms clouds when the water droplets get too heavy for the clouds and clouds too hot, and they come from the earth surface and the form of rain, and is called precipitation. Okay, so evaporation, condensation and precipitation. So what are the three states of water? Ice, water and water vapor. Which is the solid state of water? Ice. Ice is the solid state of the water. And which is the gaseous state of water? Water vapor is the gaseous state of water. And what do you mean by evaporation? The process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. The process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation, and the process of changing water vapors into water is called condensation. Okay, so in this chapter we studied about air and water, and also we studied about importance of uses of air and the properties of air, and last the importance of water. So in the earth is a planet, and the life exists in the earth is the only planet in which life exists, and the life exists in the earth due to the presence of air and water. So air and water are the two important factors that we need to live, and here we need air for breathing. And we also studied about wind and breeze. Okay, so what do you mean by wind? The fast moving air is called wind. Fast moving air is called wind, and the gentle moving air is called breeze. Gentle moving air is called breeze. Okay, and what it will be air? So air is the mixture of many gases. Air is a mixture of many gases, like examples of gases are oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, etc. So what is the spelling of oxygen? O-X-Y-G-E-N. Oxygen. Then nitrogen. N-I-T-R-O-G-E-N. Nitrogen. Carbon dioxide. And the plants need carbon dioxide in the process of photosynthesis. C-A-R-B-O-N. Carbon dioxide. D-I-O-X-I-D-E. Carbon dioxide. The plants taking carbon dioxide during photosynthesis, and it gives out oxygen, and that oxygen we use for breathing. Okay. So oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide are the main gases present in air. So air is a mixture of many gases, and we use air in many purposes, like film engine normally car tires, and we need air for breathing, etc. Okay, and we also studied about air pollution. So what do you mean by air pollution? Dirtying of air is called air pollution. Dirtying of air is called air pollution. If we breathe unclean air containing dust and germs and other particles, then it causes many diseases or many health problems. Okay, so it's our responsibility to keep our air clean. Okay, so dirtying of air means dirtying of air is called air pollution. Then we studied about water. So what is an important thing that we need to live on earth, and we cannot imagine our life without air and water. Okay, and there are three states of water. Which are the three states of water? Solid, liquid and gas. So solid, that is ice, and liquid form is water, and the gaseous form of water is water vapor. Then we studied about water cycle, and there is three processes takes place, that is evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Okay, so what do you mean by condensation? The process of changing of water vapors into water is called condensation, and the process of changing water into water vapors is called evaporation. And what do you mean by water cycle? So the changing of water in nature is called water cycle. The changing of water in nature is called in a water cycle. The changing of water in nature is called water cycle. And a water cycle takes place through the process of evaporation, condensation and precipitation. So the rain or the water comes in the surface of earth in the form of rain is called precipitation. So these are the things that we discussed in our fourth chapter. So air and water. And so in cold areas like mountains, rainwater freezes and comes down under the form of snowflakes, and during summer the snow melts and it forms streams and rivers. So again, in cold places the snowflakes or the snow melts in summers and it forms streams and rivers, and giving us fresh water throughout the year. And here in your textbook, the journey of water cycle is given. A pictorial representation is given here. Water cycle. You can see that the underground water or the water in the water bodies get evaporates, and then it forms, takes condensation and it comes in the form of comes down on the earth in the form of rain, and it is called the precipitation. And it also goes to the comes in the surface of underground water, and it goes to the water bodies, and then the water in the water bodies again converts into water vapor. Then it forms condensation, and it also comes down the surface of air in the form of water. So it's a water cycle. It's a continuous process. So it's a cyclic process. So the changing of water in the earth is called water cycle. Okay. So our fourth chapter is over. So in this chapter we also studied about atmosphere and air and water. So what do you mean by atmosphere? Atmosphere means the layer of air surrounding the earth is called atmosphere. The layer of air surrounding the earth is called atmosphere. And we studied about wind and breeze. And wind and breeze are the forms of air. And the fast moving air is called wind, and the gentle or slow moving air is called breeze. Okay. And we cannot feel air. Sorry, we cannot see air, but we can feel air when it moves. Okay. And we studied about three different states of water, and it's very important. And the three states of water are ice, water, and water vapor. Okay. So our fourth chapter is over, and then now we move to the exercise portion in your textbook, page number 130. So first question is, tick the correct option in exercise portion. Part A. First question: which of the following is essential for objects are air, water, and both of these. Here we can we already learned that air and water essential for the survival of all living things. We need air and water for survival in the earth. So these two are the answers of first question. So the answer is both of these, option C, both of these. Okay, so option C, both of these. So you take in the column, you write down near the option both of these, and you can do the answers with your pencil. Then second question, the following is a form of water. Here three options are given here: ice boat, iceberg, and ice cream. So which is the form of a water? Iceberg is the form of a water. Then third question, the changing of water in nature is called water. So the options are truck, bus, and cycle. So the changing of water in nature is called water cycle. Water cycle. So the second question, the following is a form of water. The form of water is iceberg. Option B. Okay, second question, iceberg. And third one is cycle, water cycle. Okay, option C, water cycle. Water cycle. So you take the option C, cycle. Water cycle. The changing of water in nature is called water cycle. And the fourth one is, while climbing a mountain, mountaineers carry dark cylinders, and the mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders. Option A, oxygen. O X Y G E N, oxygen. Okay, so first question, which of the following is essential for the survival of all living beings or living things? And the air and water is essential for the survival of living things. And the iceberg is a form of water. And the changing of water in nature is called the water cycle. And by climbing on mountains, mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders. And second part, B part, fill in the blanks. Okay, fill in the blanks.
Carbon dioxide. So the missing is nitrogen. So the answer
gases. Air is a mixture of gases. So what is spelling of gases? G-A-S-E-S. And third question, ice is a dark state of water. Ice is the solid state of water. Ice is the solid state of water. So answer solid, S-O-L-I-D. Then smoke makes the air polluted. Smoke makes the air polluted. P-O-L-L-U-T-E-D. Polluted. Then some gases present in the air are oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. So what is the spelling of nitrogen? N-I-T-R-O-G-E-N. Nitrogen. So these are the answers of fill in the blanks questions given in your textbook. Then the option and the part C. Define the following. Part is C. And the first question. Atmosphere. Today, let's wind up our class. Study well. Have a nice day. Thank you.